My name is Suresh. I'll be your instructor for this entire DataStage and QualityStage 9.1 session. And this session is going to be about 3 hours of duration, and daily 1 to 1.5 hour session we will be taking based on all the people availability. And we'll be having session week 6 days, and we'll be having generally on Indian Sunday morning, we'll be having holiday, and based on that also other people acceptance. Right, coming to this data stage, what I'm going to discuss, what are the topics I will be covering, and what kind of material we'll be providing, everything I'm going to discuss in today's brief introduction session. And once this is done, in next class onwards, we'll be discussing about the complete data stage. Right, I'll be starting with the data warehousing fundamentals, and the tool which we are going to discuss in our session is IBM InfoSphere DataStage and QualityStage 9.1. And here we'll be starting with the fundamentals of data warehouse. What is a data warehouse? What is the purpose of this data warehouse? Why we need a data warehouse? What is the advantage of implementing a data warehouse in the businesses? All these basics I'll be covering in 2 to 3 sessions in the fundamentals one. Once fundamentals completed, then I'll be going for the modeling part of the data warehouse also. But to discuss that part, I'll be using some of the class PPTs, like to understand the fundamentals. Even I'll be using some of the slides also, class slides also, for the understanding of this particular one. See, these all I'll also share to you. See, what is the operation system? What is the characteristic operation system? OLTP versus data warehouse, right? And what is the data warehouse? What is the purpose of a data warehouse? All these definitions, along with these definitions, I'll also be going to discussing about the some real-time examples for this. Means when I'm discussing about project architecture, I'll be giving how the project architecture will be there in data warehouse architectures process in any of the project. I'll take some banking, healthcare, like these projects. See, these fundamentals will be discussed. Once fundamentals completed, then we'll go for data modeling. I mean, what is this data modeling? Generally, who will involve in this data modeling? Data modeling is also one of the phase where we are going to implement them. Simply speaking, that okay, where we are going to have the analysis on the business data and generate the reports. For that, there are different kind of steps are there actually in the modeling. What we will be discussing in our session, what is a data model, what is the purpose of data model, and why we need a data model for this. Why for any business a data model is required, how it will be useful for the business analysis to do that one, and model, how the model will reduce the cost of change from one platform to other platform. All these we will be discussing as part of our training in the modeling classes. And we'll also discuss about the what are the different steps involved in the modeling. Generally, when we are implementing any data warehouse for any business, if you are going for a banking or healthcare or insurance or any of these businesses, there will be some model should be there, right? Means if you want to construct one building or in one house for you, you need a plan, right? Blueprint. That means you need a architectural plan. Similar to that, when you go for steps in data modeling, means this entire data modeling is going to divide into problem and scope definition, requirement gathering phase, analysis phase is going to be there, and logical database design phase, deciding the database and physical database design, finally schema generation. These are the different steps involved in this particular data model. These will be the different steps involved in general in this particular data model. And again, these are all the actual model steps are going to divide into three levels. We can simply call these data modeling steps are nothing but the levels of data modeling. That also we will discuss. How to use, I mean, this data model levels, okay, what is conceptual data modeling and what our data modeling team will do in the conceptual data modeling. How we are going to perform this conceptual data modeling in implementing of this particular data warehouse. What kind of the process will be there, right? See, entire this data modeling is divided into three levels actually. One is called conceptual data model, and second one is called logical data model, and third one is called physical data model, right? How we are going to involve in all these phases, we'll also discuss. And when you go for this modeling, especially at the time of discussion of this modeling, I'll be also using some of the model documents related to one project. Let me open that sample documents. See, there are a few sample documents for the data modeling. See, this is one of the data modeling document for healthcare project. See, I'll be explaining about the how these kind of models are going to be created by the business teams, and what kind of the data modeling will be there. I mean, what is the different type of tables we are having? If you see here, we'll be having conform dimension table, jink dimension table, and some tables are slow decision dimension table, and some are having like fact tables, facts, primary keys, foreign keys, right? Everything, these kind of tables they will be creating there. Whenever they will be creating these kind of tables, I'll also going to discuss about them. How we are going to have these tables creation, what kind of tables are going to be there, and how we are be having this table to other table relationship. Like, see, we are having two things. For example, claim detail table is there, claim header provided table is there. Claim detail table is the one which is going to have all the claims related data, right? Claim header provider is the one table which is going to have a high level header information. What is the relationship between this table to this table? Is there any relationship between this table to this table or not? Those kind of the discussion we'll be having in the all these data modeling phases. I'll be going to show you some examples for how can we do the, see, especially when you go for the conceptual data model, when you go for the logical data model, when you go for physical data model, what kind of the process we'll be having, right? I mean, as part of this training, I'll also discuss about the entire modeling piece as well. Let me open some sample. Let me show you some simple examples for this particular one. For example, member data model example, I'll be going there, see. This is the member data model example and how we are going to have this table and what kind of columns are available, see. Especially in the modeling phase, our data modeling team will identify what entities are there, what attributes are there, what is the, what are the different kind of entities they are going to specify there. All these we'll be discussing as part of our training. Okay, we will also discuss about the all these things in our training actually. While we are going to the modeling part, I will be covering everything we have these details. What is the logical data modeling? What is the physical data modeling? How we will be having this logical and physical data modeling there? what are the limitations of the logical data modeling, then we'll go for how we'll be having dimensional data modeling, what is the meaning of dimensional data modeling, what is the purpose of this dimensional data modeling, how we'll be involving in the dimensional data modeling in any of the project, right? And types of fact tables, dimension tables, if when you go for data or implementation, there are different kind of dimension tables out there. We'll also discuss about the all different types of dimension tables, like conformer dimension table, junk dimension table, fast changing dimension table, slowly changing dimension table, garbage dimension table, and all these kind of dimension tables will be also discussing how to build these kind of dimension tables with each and everything example. Okay, once this modeling part completed, see this modeling part also will take 2 to 3 classes minimum to understand. Then we'll go for a ETL process. That means once the basics and modeling part completed, we'll go for the ETL process. What is this ETL process? What is the purpose of this ETL process means? See, the tool which we are going to discuss here, the DataStage, is a one of the ETL tool, right? It's also one of the popular ETL tool. And this ETL tool will be used to develop a data warehouse. And we will also discuss as part of our training, introduction to our DataStage 9.1 version, what is the architectural components are available for this 9.1, and what are the main functions involved in this 9.1, what are the client components are there. Means, once software installed in our mission, these kind of the documents will, these kind of the client components will come to us. Documented client components will come to in our desktop. Right? In these, if you observe, the first two belongs to administrator clients. That means, once our project started, some of the administrator team will be working to set up the environment. Right? Environmental level variables will be there. Those we need to set up. And we also need to set up some kind of the national language supporting parameters. And we also need to specify users creation and allocating the roles to them. All these kind of activities we are going to perform in the things actually. I'm just showing you that, okay, if I double click on this one, I can log into this admin client component. I'm just logging there. Once software installed, you can also log in. See, right now I'm into this DataStage administrator client component. Yes, as part of our training, we'll also cover about the little bit about admin. That means basic overview about admin, what administrator client component will do, what is the purpose of administrator client component, what are all the different activities generally we'll be performing in administrator, like there are five activities we are going to perform mainly in administrator, that is web console administrator. The one is domain management, and the second one is session management, and third one is schedule management, and users, this means schedule management is also one thing, log management and users and creation, users and groups creation. This is very important. Users and groups creation means, for example, if you are logging into any other site or something, then you should always create the user ID and password, right? Once administrator created one user ID and password, then only you will be able to log into this particular any of the project, right? That users creation, if you click on users here we can create the new users. If you want to create a new user, click on the new user and specify all these details. Once we specify all these details, okay, your username will be created in the project, right? And once you create the project name, you can also allocate the different kind of roles. Now, for example, one employee moved out of this particular project, then we want to delete this project, okay, this particular guy completely, or he is completely out of this particular company itself, for example. Then in the situation, whenever he moved out of this particular company, we also need to I mean, to say that, okay, we also need to, remove his complete account, right? Or sometimes, or some particular, particular developer has only few roles, then we want to add some more roles, right? For example, initial days you are working as a developer, whenever we are working as initial days developer, now you want to work as a senior member, okay, with the many other roles to kill the jobs, to unlock the jobs or something. All these activities, if you want to perform, these will be taken care by administrator, open the roles, creation of even groups also, log management, session management. Session management means if any person log into the project, right, there'll be some session is going to create, the sessions management, everything we are going to discuss as part of our training. As part of our training, completely, we'll be discussing that one. And that's once that's completed, okay, we'll go for the DataStage development client components, like DataStage designer. What is the purpose of this DataStage designer? What we are going to do with the DataStage designer client component? How we are going to develop the DataStage jobs? Once jobs completed, okay, development, what kind of testing we'll be doing? Generally, whenever we are working on any project, right, we'll be having a different kind of the roles will be there, right? Based on our roles, we'll be working on that particular project. That may be a development project, that may be a testing project, that may be any other project also. And whenever we log into DataStage Designer, we should know how to develop a job, and we should also know how to develop a good performance job as well. Not only job, we should always develop a job with a good performance as well. That also I'll be discussing as part of our training, with performance techniques, performance tuning techniques as well, and how to convert the data stage to some other databases like Oracle, Teradata, DB2, and we'll also take care about the processing stages. Once we extract the data from our data stage, then we'll be going for the processing operation, right? Means we'll be performing different kind of operations on the data. To do the operations on the data, we are having processing stages in data stage. Yes, as part of our training, we'll also discuss that one. Debugging and development stages and creating of containers. This is another concept actually. This creating of containers is the one where we are going to have the creation of the container. For example, I developed one logic. The same logic want to develop by one of my other developer. Then instead of he also developing one more job for the same logic, what we will be doing there is, whatever the logic I developed actually, the same logic he will call in his job by using a concept called containers. Okay, we'll be having a concept of container. That container is a one which is going to maintain both these local as well as shared containers. And there are two things as well, right? One is shared containers and one is local. Local means within a job. Shared means across the project. That also we will discuss as part of our training. And we'll also discuss about routines. Actually, what is this routine? A routine is nothing but a basic language code or C++ code. You may have a question here immediately. Do I need to learn again C++? If you have already understanding of C++, some of the things we are going to write through C++ programs actually. The things which are going to write through the C++ programs is nothing but a that we are going to call as a routine. There are two types of routines we can see. One is called server routines and second one is called parallel routines. If you're writing the routines in parallel jobs, that means as we need to use C++ language, because in DataStage we have different environments are there. Server jobs are there, parallel jobs are there, mainframe jobs are there, and sequence jobs are there, right? When you go for all these environments, especially parallel job, what are the routines we are writing, right? That's going to be written in a C++ language. We'll also discuss as part of our training how to write the C++ routines as well. And I'll be also covering you guys, completely about the advanced DataStage 9.1 version stages. Then we'll go for DataStage Director Client. See, after every day, a job was developed by a developer, then he want to compile his job, he want to run his job, and we want to see the log, right? Whether this job is working as expected or the job is having any issue, those kind of the log we want to see there. Whenever we have a log like that, right, that particular log whatever we are having, that log creation, log view and log modification, and based on the log to take any other decisions, all these we'll also discuss in DataStage data client component. And there is a one more administrator. If you see, this is a DataStage designer client and this is DataStage data client, and this is called desktop administrator client actually. This desktop admin is the one client where we are going to perform that this one will be using that, okay, setting the environment, setting up the national language supporting parameters, and setting up the path specification which are required for job level, project level. All these kind of things will be performed by this particular administrator client. Administrator client here is a not a local admin, it's completely global, I mean admin for performing the all administration activities. And there is one more client, for example, this is the one IBM InfoSphere counter migration tool. This IBM InfoSphere counter migration tool is the one which is going to use to do the migration of the database stages from old version to the new version. For example, your client is using Oracle 8 database, this is an example, okay. He want to migrate their database from Oracle 8 to Oracle 11 or Oracle 10. Whenever our client want to migrate old version to the latest version, at the situation, right, when our client want to migrate from old version to latest version, for example, at the situation, we simply want to replace the existing databases with the new database stages in data stage level also. See, client is, I mean, completely decommissioning the existing database, and what are the data they have, they want to dump that into the simply new database, that's okay. But in data stage level, in data stage ETL tool also, we should do some modifications to the to support 11 version of database or 10G version of the database. To support that one, we are going for the this connection migration tool. The connection migration tool is the one which will be useful for the simply kind of the deployment we can do, or we can call as a migration. Migration of the existing database to the new database, if you want to perform, we are going to use this connection migration tool. And once a code is developed, see, the always code development is going to happen in DataStage designer client, and this data is a client where we are going to perform all the logics like view the log and everything. And there is one more client component called IBM InfoSphere Information Server Manager. What is this IBM InfoSphere Information Server Manager means? This IBM InfoSphere Information Server Manager is a client where we are going to perform the this particular client components are going to be useful for the for performing of the deployment activities from development to test, test to stage, stage to UAT, UAT to production, those kind of the code deployment. Code deployment, if you want to do, that's called we'll be using this IBM Information Server Manager. Like this, each client has its own purpose, right? When you go for them, there is one more client called Multi-Client Manager. If in case in the same mission you install DataStage old version and latest one, for example, we are involving the migration of DataStage 8.1 version to the 9.1. In the situation, our client is installed both client components on the same mission, and servers are different. In the client components also, I want to log in DataStage 8.1 first, and I want to see, and same job I want to copy into 9.1. I mean, I want to switch over between the 9.1 client components to the 8.1 client components. Then instead of manually logging both the client environments one by one each time, you can use an option called IBM InfoSphere DataStage calls it a multi-client manager. This multi-client manager is useful to switch between one version of DataStage client to the other version of DataStage client. This is only will be useful at the time of doing a migration from old version to the latest version. Like this, we'll be having multiple client components are there. All these we are going to discuss, admin port and everything. And we'll also discuss about sequence. Sequence means after any job created by any developer, right, we are going to put those jobs in a sequence. That sequence we are going to call as a batch. How to create the batch flow, what kind of batches we'll be having. How we are going to specify the batch, okay. What kind of the flow will be there for the batch specification. All these we'll also discuss as part of the training. Okay, as part of our training, we'll cover what kind of the sequence. Sequence means, see, after any job developed by developer, we need creation of the batch, and that batch will run in third-party scheduling tools, for example. Whenever that batch is running in third-party scheduling tools, right? When that particular batch is running in third-party scheduling tool specification, then that particular batch specification, whatever we are having here, in that particular batch specification, how can I call the batch? What kind of the actions, for example, in case a batch is running longer than expected time, what kind of the specifications we are having there? How to, I mean, perform these specifications here? Like, for example, if you want to run a loop, you want to expect some variables, execute command activity, all these if you want to perform, yes, we'll be having a one environment that we are going to call as a job sequencer environment. We'll also discuss as part of our training how to perform the sequencer, what kind of sequence specifications are there. All these I'll be covering as part of our training also. Okay. Next, once we are done with the sequencer part, we'll go for the quality stage. In DataStage, along with the DataStage normal development activities, we also have a separate data qualities available. There are some quality stage also available to do the check the quality of our data. What way we are going to have this quality of the data will be there, and how this quality, I mean, will be helpful for the developer to develop the job. What kind of the job specifications are there for this particular one, and how this quality stage will work on data stage level. All these we'll be discussing, especially when it comes to the quality stage also. We'll be having a different kind of the stages available for the quality. Like, let me show you some examples to you guys. Let me simply show. When you go for especially quality stage, right, along with the data stage to check the quality of our data, we'll be having, I mean, what are the main challenges we are going to face in the quality stage means? The main challenges we are going to face in the quality stage is different or inconsistent standards in structure and format or values. That's the one thing. I mean, we want to identify the structure of the data, how this data structure is there, what kind of format of the data we are receiving, and missing data and default values. How, I mean, in case if there is any missed data in a given column or given table, how to identify that and how to rectify that. Spelling errors, data may be available in wrong fields, buried information, data myopia, and data anomalies. Anomalies means duplicates. Okay, we are going to identify the duplicates in the data, and data myopia means no common key format, data is not there. And buried information means two or three fields data may be merged up into single field. Those kind of the spelling errors, data in wrong fields, okay, default values, different or inconsistent standards in structure or format or values, all these will be identifying, okay. Once identified, we will apply the quality stage. Especially in quality stage also, there are four phases are available. One is called understand the business requirement. This phase we are going to call as a re-engineering methodology. And second one is understanding the data, understanding the design and development applications, evaluate the results. All the other different phases are there. To do these all the different phases in quality stage tool, we'll be having a four main important operations are there. They're called investigate stage, standardize stage, match stage, and survive stage. All the other different kind of the operations we are going to have, and we'll be performing that also. Okay. We'll also discuss how to do the investigation operation, how to do the, all these as part of our daily training. Once this quality stage is completed, we'll go to the project. After the class completion of the complete course for this one, then we'll go for a one project discussion also. In the project, first I'll be starting with the what the business requirements are there, how we'll be having BRDs, from BRDs how we are going to create the dimension tables and fact tables, and how modeling team create the physical data model, logical data model, and conceptual data modeling things. Then what is the flow of your subject area, how many subject areas you are having in your project, how we are going to have a HLD and LLDs for the project flow. We'll be also discussing about the how to perform the complex job design. See, in case if you are working as a developer, you also need some of the complex situations where you face, where you feel, yes, it's critical, I need some help, I need something. Those not basic situations, maybe in basic situations also you can take some help from any of your colleagues or friends, but some kind of critical situations, yes, it will going to really help, I mean, need a help to you to develop the job. Those kind of situations, how you are developed and what kind of unit testing you performed. Okay, because after development completed every day, we'll be also performing the some of the unit testing generally for the jobs, how to perform that unit testing, and system and user acceptance testing and regression and intent testing, deployment process of the code for the different phases of the deployment, okay, end-to-end testing, creation of job design document and documents how to do, and once development is completed, generally every project will go to the production environment, right? Once the project is in the production environment, what kind of scripts we are writing for automating the code and production support process, and discussion of scheduling process with the control MR autosys tools, fixing of defects and problem tickets and incidents, how to fix the defects and what kind of problem tickets we are having, what kind of incident we are having, all those things. To discuss this entire project flow, it will take 10 to 15 hours of duration, and course will take 35 to 40 hours, totally it will take 50 plus hours of duration only will be spending to discuss all these things. Okay, and apart from this, when you go for the class, I'll be providing all the plenty of materials which will be useful for the understanding of the basics, tool, and understanding of the teradata materials. Also I'll be providing Unix scripts also which are required for the for the project to understand, quality stage information analyzer materials, and ETL testing related materials, how can we do the testing and everything, data resume basics materials, and tool materials, especially parallel jobs and server jobs materials, class PPTs which I'm going to use in the class, okay, I'm going to share those also, some of the modeling PPTs and project materials, okay, all these I'm going to share as part of our training. Okay, that's all in today's introduction to just demo session. If anyone having any questions, you can ask me. I'm more happy to answer your questions. And one more thing I just want to mention here, software installations also will be taken care of by our team, and they'll be installing software on your machine based on your machine configuration. Any questions here in the demo session?
Hi, Suresh.
Yep. Yep.
Yeah, this is Nitin. Okay. One question, like now, how are we going to perform on like a hands-on lab or practical stuff, like you will provide some guidance or something, or we need to do as you do like in a simultaneously or something, or we can perform later on as an exercise or something, or what?
Right. That's actually based on your availability. We are going to prefer, okay, every time simultaneously when the class is going, at the time you can start practicing parallelly, or if you don't have availability at the time, okay, after that also you can practice. I'll be sharing some of the sessions also, recorded sessions of the class every day. For example, we took the class today, after this class completion, you will be getting the recording of the total class, and that will be, you can use as the reference while you are practicing. And I'll be giving as part of material, okay, some of the exercises, I mean some of the project related exercises to you. Those you can use as a reference to practice, start practicing the data. And along with that, yes, you will also get to receive some of the interview questions, which will be useful for the understanding of the how the interview patterns will be there, what things need to be prepared, everything. That I'll be providing in day one of the class itself, everything. And practicing, yes, I'll always recommend you guys to start parallelly. If you don't have a time to start a parallel something, yes, if you are even you are practicing after sessions also, but you'll be having in hand, you have the recording of the class. You can use that one as a reference and you can practice. Any other questions by anyone?
No.
Okay, fine, then we will meet on next session, and I'll ask Bucket team to update the session details and everything, with, and they'll also provide you software stuff and everything. Okay. Thanks for joining. We'll meet on next session.